either like to stand up or you like to sit up, right? I prefer to stand up to sit out. Some people are the other way around. Some people really like off the bat sitting in their butt. You know, instead of quarter turn here, you know, you kick that foot out, you sit, you make them follow you. It's kind of a potato potato thing. It doesn't really matter if you're comfortable with either one. The sit out, in general, I think it can come from a couple of different places. Like I said, if you wanted to go to that instead of the stand up, you could do that. The issue, well, I guess it's not really an issue. If you're here, you get shot down, you can definitely just shoulder roll into a quarter turn, 4 seconds sit out. Right? Like it works in with everything. I kind of wanted to separate it because it is kind of its own little different thing. Like the sit, the stand ups, and the tripods and all that stuff kind of go together. And then the shoulder rolling, catching wrists. Now I want to touch on sit ups. So here it can be, you can go to this, just it's the same motions. Everything's the same. Off the whistle, beat this in, sit here. Right? Now when I'm here, I want to keep this arm sealed, right? So I keep this arm sealed throughout the whole thing. Seal. Foot. Second quarter. The only difference is I'm kicking that leg through. Alright? Now I'm on my butt. Two hands on one hand here. I like to post it to the mat. Like this. Heist out. And away. So again, he's on top. Here, first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get my pressure to get my weight back. And I'm gonna seal here. I'm gonna step, quarter turn, sit my butt. See how I'm gonna follow me, comes around behind. Now, two hands on one hand here, post, just like this. Turn it up, ice those hips. It can also come from a step back, right? If I come here, quarter turn up, and he gives me a real hard kick back, boom. You gotta be able to run these sit-ups, regardless of whether you don't want to be here, because you might end up here from something like this. Quarter turn up, suck back, top, seal here, heist away. Any questions on that? And again, like I just went over, seal, heist, hip, sit. He chops me this way, he chops me that way, shoulder roll, quarter turn, right to another sit out, or I can quarter turn up, right to the trap down this side. It just, there's an infinite amount of options. You can go from one thing to the next thing, to the next thing, to the next thing, and it keeps you moving, keeps you active on bottom, and it makes that top guy just want to say, screw it, kick it, I'm going to try my luck on my feet. That's what we want. We want to always be able to get that one point, guys. We always want to be able to get that one point at the beginning of each match. Because if I'm not good enough to go under a guy, it's the same in reverse as if you're good on top. If I'm good on top, I know like he doesn't want to go underneath me, right? So I basically start up on him. That's how I think though. It's the same in reverse if you're bad on bottom. If you're bad on bottom, you got to assume that guy's going to go under you and get his escape. If you can't do it, then essentially you're starting down. Alright? You gotta be moving, gotta have this, you gotta get flowing with this series, these movements. Alright? You gotta start working and feeling the chops and the shoulder rolls and the wrist grabs. This stuff all comes as you get more comfortable running this stuff. But if you just sit down there and suck on the mat the whole time, you're not getting any reps in, let alone. Are you gonna get your escape? Right? Does this all make sense? Sit out, try to run a little bit through some of the series I went through, and try to sub in some of those quarter turns or tripods for a couple of sit outs. Partner, be a good partner, and he goes to his butt. When he goes to his butt, I want you to be here in good position, looking and trying to chop anything right here. I don't want you to just be kind of like, you know, whatever. I want you to be in good position, trying to get that up, get underneath those arms, trying to get hand control, and try to take him to the side where you want. Right? If I'm behind a guy, right, my goal needs to be taken to the side here and cover. Right? I need to get him flat. And from that, if he's going to go from a sit-out to parterre on his knee, or freeze, whatever you call it,